إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters in Islam, there is no doubt that the purpose behind our creation is to achieve servitude to Allah. That is why you were created, to be a servant of Allah, to submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال الله تعالى, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I have not created the two races, the race of Satan, jinn, and the race of Adam, the humans, but to worship me. And a sign of your success, that you depart and you leave this world as a Muslim. That is the sign of success. Therefore, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, calling upon you, يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. O ye who believe, have taqwa, righteousness and piety, submit to Allah the way that He deserves, and don't you dare die but as Muslims. So me and you are in a quest to die as Muslims. But along the way, we get weak. We start straying away. Because by default, كل ابن آدم خطاء. As in Sahih, as in Sunan al-Tirmidhi, bi sanadin Sahih, min hadith Anas, radiyallahu anhu. All the children of Adam are subject to sinning. We're not perfect. We're subject to making mistakes. We're not perfect. Yet we are in a quest to die as Muslims. Yet we are in a quest to achieve that servitude to Allah, to the best of our capacity. But yet, we're weak. We make mistakes. we fall because of Satan, because of your own nafs, because of the people that you hang around with. These are the three enemies who are trying to get you in trouble and drive you away from that path of submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But there is a blessing that we have in this religion, that every year we're given a second chance. Allah grants this ummah every year a second chance. You know, when you have a laptop or a computer, and then got messed up because of the sites that you go to, spams, viruses, all type of things. And then the technician tells you it's better to buy a new computer. But there is an option out there that you could take the date back. You could actually give it a new date. You can have a new beginning. You can have a new beginning. And that chance is always granted with a guest that visits every Muslim every year. I'm talking about the dear guest who will be arriving in 7 to 8 days. My question to my brothers and my sisters in Islam, are you ready for that guest? Are you ready for Ramadan? Do you want that second chance or not? Do you want to have a new beginning or not? النبي إخوة دعا, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam supplicated, invoked Allah against someone whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala extends his life to live through the month of Ramadan, and he comes out of it unforgiven. والحديث في سنن الترمذي من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, one day he went up his pulpit 3 steps, he said 3 times, آمين آمين آمين. Then he faced his companions and he explained to them, Jibreel came and he made dua against someone who lives through Ramadan, comes out of it unforgiven. And I said, Ameen too. رغم أنف امرئ أو رجل أدرك رمضان ولم يغفر له. Why? اسمع. من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. If you fast Ramadan out of belief, following the sunnah, seeking the reward, Allah will give you forgiveness from all your previous sins. من قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Whoever stands in Salatul Qiyam at night, whether at home or whether with the Imam in the Masjid, إيمانا واحتسابا, Allah will forgive all his previous sins. من قام ليلة القدر إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. If Allah subhanahu, if you do laylatul, observe laylatul qadr in the last 10 nights of Ramadan, not the night of the 27th, it is possible, but it's hidden in the last 10 nights of Ramadan. If you do qiyam and ibadah, Allah will forgive all your previous sins. طب شياطين, الحديث في مسلم أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه, إذا كان أول ليلة من رمضان, when Ramadan is here, when Ramadan arrives, فتحت أبواب الجنة, the doors of Jannah are open, the doors of the hellfire are locked, وصفدت الشياطين. We blame شيطان all the time. Why يا أخي شيطان شيطان شيطان؟ أهو شياطين are chained for you. What is your excuse? What? Why? If you don't earn it, then you're not interested in it. That's why the dua was made against you. You're not, your agenda, you're basically thinking that forgiveness is really nothing. Forgiveness is really nothing. You don't care about it. What forgiveness? What for what? What? What for what? Akhirah, akhi. Akhirah. My brothers and sisters in Islam, Ramadan is just a week or almost 10 days away from you, 8 days, more or less. Are you ready for that month? When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was asked about the month of Sha'ban by Usama ibn Zayd, kama fi Sunan al-Nasa'i, how come, O Messenger of Allah, you fast a lot in Sha'ban? You know what he said, sallallahu alaihi wasallam? ذاك شهر بين رجب ورمضان. It is a month that falls between Rajab and Ramadan. يغفل عنه كثير من الناس. A lot of the Muslims are not paying attention to the month of Sha'ban. You know what you need to do in the month of Sha'ban, brothers and sisters in Islam? I said Ramadan is a guest. And before you receive a guest, you clean your house. You don't wait till the guest arrives and then you say, excuse me, let me make the bed for you. Can I do the kitchen for you? Can I? No, before he arrives. Akhi, I'm coming to visit you in 1 hour. Run. Buy stuff. Get ready for the guest. Are you ready for the guest? That is where people are not paying attention to Sha'ban, because in Sha'ban, you clean the house. And the house is here. You gotta clean that house. If you want to earn forgiveness, you gotta clean it, brothers. You gotta clean it. Otherwise, it's gonna be taken care of in the day of resurrection. And you don't want that. My brothers and sisters in Islam, any type of sinning, shortcomings, faults that we do, were referred to in our revelation by ظلم, injustice. Injustice. Whether this injustice is committed against yourself, you, or committed against Allah, you actually could commit injustice against Allah, or injustice that is committed against another human being. These are the three areas of injustices that you must take care of before Ramadan is here. هذا قول يعني ورد في حديث في مستدرك الحاكم ومسند الإمام أحمد من حديث عائشة رضي الله عنها. But the scholars of hadith weaken the chain of narration, but it is supported. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم actually said this. دواوين الظلم ثلاث. In the day of resurrection, there are three types of injustices that you're going to be asked about. Three. دواوين الظلم ثلاث. Three records of injustices. The first of which, ظلم العبد لربه. That you commit injustice against Allah. وهذا لا يغفر يوم القيامة. And this one, if you do not come out of it in the dunya, it will not be forgiven in the day of resurrection. وأنا تحدث عن الشرك والكفر. قال تعالى إن الله لا يغفر أن يشرك به ويغفر ما دون ذلك لمن يشاء. الله سبحانه وتعالى will never forgive you associating someone in worship with him in the day of resurrection. In the dunya you can come out of it. In the dunya you can. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about the Christians, لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْمَسِيحُ بْنُ مَرْيَمُ. Disbelievers are those who say, Al-Masih is Allah. لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ ثَالِثُ ثَلَاثَةَ. Disbelievers are those, Allah is one of three. And then at the end, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَفَلَا يَتُوبُونَ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَيَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. في الدنيا. Why shouldn't they do tawheed? Why shouldn't they worship Allah alone and ask Allah to forgive them for their shortcomings? Why shouldn't they say La ilaha illallah? Wallahu ghafoor rahim. And if they do it, I will accept it from them. قُلْ لِلَّذِينَ كَافَرُوا إِنْ يَنْتَهُوا يُغْفَرْ لَهُمْ مَا قَدْ سَلَفْ. Tell the disbelievers of Muhammad, someone who worships an idol, if they stop and worship Allah in the dunya, all their sins in the past will be erased. Oh. وَكَمَا قَالَ النَّبِيُّ لَعَمْرِ بْنَ الْعَاصِ وَالْإِسْلَامُ يَجُبُّ مَا قَبْلَ. You saying La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah, even so you worshipped so many idols. Done. But you die as a mushrik, لا يغفر لك. بل يحبط عملك. ولقد أوحي إليك يا محمد. It was revealed to you, O Muhammad, وإلى الذين من قبلك, and to those messengers before you, لئن أشركت لا يحبطن عملك. If you commit shirk, even if you did righteous deeds, these deeds are not going to benefit you. الحمد لله نحن موحدون. We say لا إله إلا الله, محمد رسول الله, is a blessing from Allah that you are there. But make sure that you filter your intentions. Make sure that it's taken the route of sincerity in all that you do. As for the second type of injustice that you have to take care of, ظلم العبد لنفسه. Injustice that you commit against your own self. A sin that you commit, you do not engage another person. تدخل غرفة, you go inside a room and you do your thing. You're by yourself somewhere, you do your thing. You go into the Google and you go into these websites and the videos and all these haram pornography stuff. Stuff like that. Zina, Allah knows best. Things that you do in the hidden, and Allah sees you. يعني سبحان الله, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said about لا يعبأ الله بها. Allah will forgive this one. And there are so many ways for this to be forgiven. الاستغفار, if you commit that sin, if you became weak and you did it and you say استغفر الله, oh Allah forgive me, I made a mistake, Allah will forgive it. توبة, you make توبة. Actually, الصلاه, الجمعة هذه, الجمعة, that's a lot of my Muslim brothers, they come late to it. الجمعة, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان في صحيح مسلم. الصلوات الخمس, the five daily prayers. والجمعة إلى الجمعة, from جمعة to جمعة. رمضان إلى رمضان, رمضان, you're actually reaching رمضان. مكفرات لما بينهن. They will expiate your sins, but with one condition, إِذَا مَجْتُنِبَتِ الْكَبَائِرِ, if you stay away from the major sins. في حاجة اسمها الحسنات الماحية, حسنات ماحية, that if you commit a sin, then you rush, do a good deed. كما قال النبي لحبه معاذ, اتبع السيئة الحسنة تمحها. Follow a bad deed with a good deed. If you committed a sin in secret, go give sadaqah in secret. Ya Rab, forgive me that sin, Ya Rab, in secret. وقال تعالى, إن الحسنات يذهبن السيئات. They call them erasing sins, erasing حسنات. And if you don't do all of this, there is something called المصائب المكفرة. مصائب. You don't do استغفار. You don't keep up with the five daily prayers. You don't keep up with the Jummah. You don't keep up with Ramadan. You don't ask Allah to forgive you. You don't do حسنات في مصائب. مصيبة تنزل كده. Disasters. calamities. If you receive these calamities, actually it will erase your sins. Erase your sins. لو احتسبتها وصبرت. If you're patient. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ذكر كما في الصحيح حتى الشوكة. You're in the kitchen like this and your head hit like this. And he said, Alhamdulillah. هذه actually will expiate your sins. But saying gush and dun and all these things, no. Oh. I say, Alhamdulillah, khalas. Will expiate a sin. مصائب. And if you don't do all of this, يا أخي سبحان الله, يعني هناك حديث يبعث الأمل. والله يا إخوة, والله كلنا, including me, we're in trouble. But look, listen to this. حديث اسمه حديث النجوى في الصحيحين. حديث ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, يدني رب العالمين المؤمن منه يوم القيامة فيضع عليه كنفه. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring you near to him in the day of resurrection. You, I'm talking to you. Allah will speak to each one of us in the day of resurrection. Oh, you, I'm talking to you, Allah. You will speak to you, Allah. ما منكم من أحد إلا وسيكلمه ربه يوم القيامة ليس بينه وبينه ترجمان. Without a translator, he will speak to you. And then he will ask in secret. It's called secret consultation. الحديث اسمه حديث النجوى. Secret talk between you and Allah. Private talk between you and Allah. طيب أتذكر ذنب كذا وكذا يوم كذا وكذا. Do you remember in this day you went inside that place and you committed that sin? Say نعم يا رب. Yes يا رب. I did it يا رب. Again. أتذكر يوم كذا وكذا ذنب كذا وكذا. Do you remember on this day you committed that sin? نعم يا رب. نعم يا رب. As many as his sins are, then the believer will think that he is doomed. He's about to be dragged to the hellfire. He just confessed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell him, سترتها عليك في الدنيا واليوم أغفرها لك. I veiled you in the dunya. I did not disgrace you. Even so, I saw you. I did not disgrace you in front of the people. And today I will forgive it for you. I will forgive you today. The third type of injustices, brothers and sisters in Islam, this is the hard one. This is the difficult one. Injustices that you commit to another human being. Your own, another human being. You must pay for this one in the day of resurrection. If you don't take care of it in this world. Period. Period. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كما في صحيح البخاري, من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه, اسمع هذا. من كان له مظلمة عند أخيه فليتحلله منها. If you have committed injustice to another person, to another brother, under freedom of speech and all that stuff, we have actually, brothers, we have ethics different to that free of speech thing. Typing emails back and forth, ooh, ooh. لا كل هذا والله ستسأل عن كل كلمة. Every word that you wrote, you will be asked about it. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, إن الرجل لا يتكلم بالكلمة من سخط الله لا يلقي لها بالة فتهوي به في النار 70 خريفة. A man will speak a word, just one word, one word, carelessly. He's not paying attention. One word. He's not paying attention, just one word. But that word earned him the wrath of Allah. And it will be the reason for him to fly into the hellfire 7 years. فمظالم هذه مشكلة. مشكلة. أنت ستقف أمام ربك يوم القيامة. You will stand before your Lord in the day of resurrection. يعني you may be able to convince a judge or a person or an imam of your case, but if you're lying, Allah knows that you're lying. If you're making this up, Allah knows that you're making this up. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كما في الصحيحين من حديث أم سلمة رضي الله عنها يقول لأصحابه, one day when they brought to him an issue, إنكم تختصمون إلي. You bring to me your disputes. وإنما أنا بشر. I'm a human being. ولعل أحدكم أن يكون ألحن بحجته من حجة أخيه. And it may be some of you are eloquent in expressing their case. Good in typing. Good in typing, good in talking, but he knows that he is lying. He knows that is not true. He knows, or she knows. By the way, I'm not talking about any specific individual. In general, Nabi Sallam tells them, "You may be able to convince me of your case, but you know you're at fault. But if I give you something that does not belong to you, rest assured, I'm giving you a piece of fire. Fire. فالمواضيع يا إخوة مش بالغلبة والله ستسأل, والله ستسأل عن هذا الكلام. أنا قرأت حديث هذا الصباح, والله أنا لأول مرة أقرأ هذا الحديث. It's the first time I read this hadith. يعني the first time. حديث في مسند أبي يعلى سعيد بن أنس عن أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه. He said this, one day we were sitting, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sitting with his companions. فضحك, he smiled. فقال له عمر, عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه, said to him, O Messenger of Allah, فديناك بآبائنا وأمهاتنا, لما تضحك, why are you smiling? قال, he said, رجلان من أمتي, two individuals from my ummah, جاثيين أمام رب العزة يوم القيامة, kneeling in front of Allah in the day of resurrection. فيقول, one of them will say to Allah, يا رب خذ مظلمتي من أخي, he wronged me in the dunya, يا رب, take it back, settle it for me, ya Rab. I was unable, I did not have enough people to rally behind me. I was weak, ya Rab. I did not have a good lawyer, ya Rab. I did not have money to pay, ya Rab. Take my right. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask the oppressor, أعطي لأخيك حقه. Give him your right. Give him his right. يقسم يقول والله يا رب ما بقي من حسناتي شيء. I don't have any more good deeds. You see, in the day of resurrection, disputes are going to be settled through your good deeds. حسنات is the hard currency in the day of resurrection. حتى المشرك يسأله ربه لو أن لك ما في الأرض ذهب وفضة أتفتدي بها من عذاب يوم القيامة, ما تقبل. Even if you possess the gold and silver the size of this world, will not help you. The currency in the day of resurrection is a hard currency called good deeds and bad deeds. That's the dealing in the day of resurrection. I backbit you, okay, أخي, you got my Jum'ah, take it. I gossiped about you, here is my night of Ramadan, حسنة خذها. هذا هكذا. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لما سأل أصحابه كما في صحيح مسلم حديث أبي هريرة, أتدرون ما المفلس؟ Who is the bankrupt? قالوا يا رسول الله, they said, O Messenger of Allah, المفلس من لا درهم له ولا متاع. The bankrupt, chapter 13, chapter 7, whatever the chapters these days, is someone who does not have cash nor assets. لا 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 لا. No, 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 no. المفلس من أمتي. The bankrupt from my ummah. يأتي يوم القيامة. Someone who will come in the day of resurrection. بصلاة, he prayed 5 times. زكاة, he paid the زكاة. صيام, he fasted. حج. But at the same time, backbit this person, gossiped about this person, cheated this person, lied about this person. طيب, how is you going to pay this? Money? $10? Can I give you a cashier check? لا لا لا. فيؤخذ هذا من حسناته. He will pay them back with his good deeds. طب what happened if he runs out of good deeds? He will receive their bad deeds. So واحد بيشرب خمر مثلا ولا مخدرات, انت تاخذ السيئة بتاعته. He is getting high and you're receiving his bad deeds because he gossiped about him, because he liked to run the mouth. When the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told Mu'adh, hold this Mu'adh, hold it Mu'adh. Ya Rasulallah, people go to the hellfire because of this? Yes, ya Mu'adh. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم من يضمن لي ما بين فكيه وما بين فخذيه أضمن له الجنة. Whoever guarantees for me this limb and this limb, I guarantee جنة for him. فمسألة الفري سبيتش ومش عارف ايه والكلام الطيب هذا ما يمشيش مع المسلمين, ما ينفع. This is fine in a, but not towards your brother. يا إخوة, يا إخوة, والله ستسأل عن كل كلمة. You will be asked about every single word in the day of resurrection. And you better take care of it in this world. You better, before it's too late. I go back to Hadith Anas. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell this person, give your brother his right back. Then he will say, Ya Rabbi, I run out of hasanat. I have no hasanat. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask the oppressed, what do you want him to do? Say, Ya Rab, let him take my sins. يحمل أوزاري يا رب. He must carry my sins, O Allah. بكى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. فاضت عيناه. Says, in a day like this, and you have to carry the sins of somebody else. هذا اليوم يا إخوة 50,000 years long. You're standing naked. People are soaking in their sweat. The sun is 1 mile away from the head. The hellfire will be brought in front of you. وجيء يومئذ بجهنم. قال النبي على ابن مسعود, روى ابن مسعود عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, يؤتى بجهنم لها 70,000 زمام, مع كل زمام 70,000 ملك يجرونه. Hellfire has 70,000 leashes. Angry hellfire, angry, upset. And you're still going to have, instead of dealing with your own sins, you receive the sins of another person. Why? Because you committed injustice against him. يا إخوة, حتى والله حتى الدين, حتى غير المسلمين. يعني في صحيح ابن حبان, جابر بن عبد الله رضي الله عنهما narrates that one day the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم asked his companions who went to Abyssinia. We know that at the beginning of the Islam, may I ask the brothers to move a little bit so we can accommodate the brothers who are standing? Come closer to one another, inshallah. We'll be done soon here, inshallah. He asked the companions who migrated to Abyssinia, ألا تحدثوني بأعاجيب ما رأيتم في أرض الحبشة. Can you tell me something that is so amazing that you saw in Habasha, in Abyssinia? One of them spoke and he said, Ya Rasulallah, one day I was sitting down and an old nun was walking and carrying in her head a jar of water. A young man came from behind and he pushed her. She fell down in her face and her jar broke. And then she turned to him and she said this to him, سوف تعلم يا غدر. One day, you committer of a treason, you will know one day. حين يوضع الكرسي, when the throne of Allah will be set in the land of gathering. ويجمع الله الأولين والآخرين. And Allah will gather all human beings from Adam till the last soul born. وتتكلم الأيدي والأرجل. And the hands that tied will speak. And the feet will speak. Yes, I tied. Yes, I hit. Yes, I walked. ما أمري وأمرك عند الله. فقال النبي صدقت صدقت. She spoke the truth. Allah will settle that dispute. يا إخوة حتى الحيوانات والله the animals. يعني أنا أعجب لهذا الأمر. أعجب الحيوانات. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كما في مسند الإمام من حديث أبي ذر. He was walking with أبي ذر الغفاري رضي الله عنه. They saw two sheep knocking one another. حيوانات knocking one another. فقال له يا أبا ذر أو أبا ذر أتدري فيما تنططحان. Do you know why they are knocking one another down? It's very hard. If you have two cats at home, you see them by all of a sudden fighting, but you never know why, what caused that fight. Probably a half hour ago, somebody did something, and you really, for you to figure this out, you have to keep them under the microscope or something. He said, لا يا رسول الله. Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, ولكن الله يعلم وسيقضي بينهم يوم القيامة. But Allah knows and He will settle their disputes in the day of resurrection. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم كما في صحيح مسلم حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه لتؤدن الحقوق أو لتؤدن أو لتؤدن الحقوق إلى أهلها حتى يقاد حتى يقاد للشاة القرناء الشاة القرناء من الشاة الجلحاء الشاة الجلحاء من الشاة القرناء. The hornless sheep without horns will get its right back from the sheep with a horn. فهو حيوانات وسيقضي بينهم يوم القيامة. فإياك والظلم. You're still alive. Ramadan is coming. It's time to make up with your brothers. It's time to make up with your sisters. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله. My brothers and sisters in Islam, قال الله تعالى, الله سبحانه وتعالى says, لا خير في كثير من نجواهم إلا من أمر بصدقة أو معروف أو إصلاح بين الناس. There is no goodness in everything that you speak, openly or secretly, except in these three areas. Give صدقة أخي, help. This is bad, don't do it. Or you make up between two brothers. لا خير في كثير من نجواه إلا من أمر بصدق أو معروف أو إصلاح بين الناس. That you make up between two parties, two brothers, two communities. شوف هذه. ومن يفعل ذلك ابتغاء مرضات الله فسوف نؤتيه أجرا عظيما. And whoever does this just for the sake of Allah, he's not favoring this party over this party, just for the truth, just to set the record straight, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him a great reward. I'm sure the majority of you are aware of the situation at ICP. أن والله يا إخوة أشهد الله سبحانه وتعالى ما حركني إلا هذه الآية. I came because of this verse. I want that reward. And I did not come by myself. I have two brothers. Both of them are lawyers. And we're here to help you resolve that situation and move forward. Ramadan is coming. It is not fair to this community to dwell in this during this month when we are all sinners, including me, and seekers of forgiveness. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كما في سنن الترمذي وأبي داود من حديث أبي الدرداء رضي الله عنه, he said to his companions one day, ألا أدلكم على أفضل من درجة الصيام والصلاة والصدقة. Can I tell you something that is much better than the voluntary fasting? That's how it should be understood. The voluntary salah, the voluntary sadaqah, the extras, more than the zakah. قالوا بلى يا رسول الله. He said, yes, O Messenger of Allah. He said, إصلاح ذات البين. That you make up. فاتقوا الله وأصلحوا ذات بينكم. Fix it. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم says, ألا إن فساد ذات البين هي الحالقة. Having conflicts is the eraser. ولا أقول تحلق الشعر is not the eraser of the hair. The eraser of the deen. It erases your deen. I'm not from this community. I've been visiting this community. I came to help. But I tell you, if the community is not willing to change the hearts, it's not going to happen. You cannot force this. I mean, we can force on you some laws and then we're going to go to where we came from. But if the good people in this community are not willing to make it work, it's going to be too difficult for us. We're here just for the weekend and then we're coming, inshallah, the first Ramadan, the first Jum'ah in Ramadan, announce the result of the arbitration. Khalas. Now, it's you. It's you. I am an imam in a mosque that maybe four times this size. But I always say this. This community is more valuable than this community there. You know why? Because of your location. You have a golden opportunity to pass on this deen to non-Muslims. What are you doing about this? You have a golden opportunity to teach your children the deen. What are you doing about this? Do you have a school here? Do you have a hafz program here? What are you doing about this? Why are we dwelling in conflicts and leaving what we need to do? We got to think about it, brothers, for the sake of Allah. And I know some of you, I'm going to finish inshallah in 2 minutes. Some of you may have to pardon, may have to forgive. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says three things that I'm willing to take an oath on. One of them, وَمَا زَادَ اللَّهُ عَبْدًا بِعَفْوٍ إِلَّا عِزَّةٍ. Allah will increase someone who forgives glory in the dunya. Inshallah, after the khutbah, myself and brother Qusair, you could call him both ways, are going to update you regarding the proceeding tomorrow. And we're expecting the third party will arrive around 5 o'clock this afternoon. And brother Shariq, I guess he visited the community before. And tomorrow, inshallah, is the hearing. And basically, we're open to hear everybody. The brothers actually and myself as a shura decided that we're going to have an open hearing, but without any violation. I will be out there. without any violation to the ethics of Islam. We want this to be a healing experience to the community. Get it off your chest, done, move forward. End of story. Leave it. الدنيا يا إخوة will vanish. دنيا vanish. والله أنا رأيت هذا بأم عيني. أدفن رجل في مصر. In Egypt I was burying somebody. After I buried him. And this person comes and cries in front of the grave. Cries. And putting sand in his head. I said, what's wrong with you? I said, this is my brother. I did not speak to him for 20 years. And now he's gone. He's in the next world. There's nothing I can do about it. For 20 years. Because of $10,000 Egyptian pounds. $2,000. ما ينفع يا إخوة. فين الإيمان؟ Where is إيمان؟ Where is faith? Where is the آخرة؟ ما ينفع هذا في أمة المسلمين. هذا عمل الشيطان in the community. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لأصحابه. He said to his companions, إن الشيطان آيس أن يعبد. الشيطان giving up the fact that he will be for worshipped again. But he will do something. تحريش بينكم. Get you fighting one another. That's what Shaitan will do. I know my mission is not easy because I'm actually going against the current of Shaitan. We're coming to make peace. Shaitan wants it to this to continue. Shaitan wants this to continue. Shaitan wants that conflict to dwell and live. We want to fix it. I call upon the good people in this community. And Allah knows your goodness. Don't say I'm good. Allah knows your goodness. Let's help out the cause of Allah and defeat the cause of Shaitan and bring peace to ICP, inshaAllah. Allahumma aghfir lana dunubana wa israfana fi amrina wa thabbit aqdamana wa ansurna ala alqawm alkafirin. Allahumma arina alhaqqa haqqan warzuqna ittiba'ah wa arina albatila batilan warzuqna ijtinabah. Allahumma ahdina wahdi bina واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى يا رب العالمين. اللهم أصلح بنا يا أكرم الأكرمين. اللهم استعملنا في طاعتك يا رب. اللهم استعملنا في طاعتك يا رب العالمين. إن شاء الله. I know I kept you for too long, but we're gonna need another half hour of your time if you want. Our brother Qasir is going to update you regarding the process tomorrow, and he will actually take questions from you if you want to give input.